Welcome to Main Street Living. This program offers you the opportunity to participate in a worship service led by pastors and congregations of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod from your surrounding area. On today's program,
salvation is possible only by the gospel, only by the perfect life of the only good man laid down in sacrifice for sins. Only by faith in that atoning sacrifice, the right spiritual GPS way to everlasting salvation is trusting in Jesus Christ alone, who is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes.
The service will begin with this opening hymn.
Good morning. I'm Pastor Robert Mays from Emmanuel and Zion St. John Lutheran Churches in Beamer and Wisner, Nebraska. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us then confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us. Renew us. And lead us so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake God forgives us all our sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. May the Lord, who has begun this good work in us, bring it to completion in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The Old Testament reading is written in the book of Amos, chapter 5. The prophet Amos declares the inspired word of God, and he proclaims, "Seek the Lord and live, lest he break out like fire in the house of Joseph, and it devour, with none to quench it for Bethel. O you who turn justice to wormwood and cast down righteousness to the earth, they hate him who reproves in the gate, and they abhor him who speaks the truth. Therefore, because you trample on the poor and you exact taxes of grain from him, you have built houses of hewn stone, but you shall not dwell in them. You have planted pleasant vineyards, but you shall not drink their wine. For I know how many are your transgressions and how great are your sins. You who afflict the righteous, who take a bribe and turn aside the needy in the gate. Therefore, he who is prudent will keep silent in such a time, for it is an evil time. Seek good and not evil that you may live. And so the Lord, the God of hosts, will be with you, as you have said. Hate evil and love good, and establish justice in the gate. It may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will be gracious to the remnant of Joseph." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The epistle lesson is written in Hebrews chapter 3. The writer gives us the inspired word of God. He writes, "Take care, brothers, lest there be in any of you an evil, unbelieving heart, leading you to fall away from the living God. But exhort one another every day, as long as it is called today, that none of you may be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. For we have come to share in Christ, if indeed we hold our original confidence firm to the end. As it is said, today if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. For who were those who heard and yet rebelled? Was it not all those who left Egypt led by Moses? And with whom was he provoked for 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, whose bodies fell in the wilderness? And to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest, but to those who were disobedient? So we see that they were unable to enter because of unbelief. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel is according to St. Mark, the 10th chapter. And as Jesus was setting out on his journey, a man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" And Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments. Do not murder, do not commit adultery, do not steal, do not bear false witness, do not defraud, honor your father and mother." And he said to him, "Teacher, all these I have kept from my youth." And Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, "You lack one thing. Go, sell all that you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And come, follow me." Disheartened by the saying, he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. We confess our Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Grace, mercy, and peace to you. From God, our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, if you are going the wrong way, you get lost. You can't always get there from here. Not if your path takes you the wrong direction. If you do find yourself going the wrong way because directions were bad or maybe the GPS had a glitch, then you have to turn around and go back the right way. Now, what is common sense for using directions is not so common when it comes to finding everlasting salvation. For people think they know the right way to find everlasting salvation, but they end up horribly lost. It's worse than being horribly lost with directions. Being horribly lost with salvation means you are going to hell. In our gospel text, the rich young man had a bad spiritual GPS. First, he runs up to Jesus and kneels before him, and we start to think, all right, maybe this guy is a believer too. He's kneeling before the Lord, which, you know, many good churches do for communion, and he's run up to Jesus because maybe he knows Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. But then the guy speaks, and you see he is dead set on following the wrong path. Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And then comes that moment where believing Christians have to pick up their jaws that just fell to the ground. What do you mean? What must you do? That's the wrong question. Like trying to get to Alaska by digging deep into the earth. You're never going to get there that way. The reason is because your good works are not enough to save you. In order for works to save you, you must have done everything 100%. Leave anything out, and you've missed your chance. So you got annoyed when your wife wanted you to do more on a home project? Or you got bothered because your husband put off doing some things you asked him to do? Neither of these are in the marriage vows. Or maybe you think you deserve better than what God in his infinite wisdom has given you. So far, your works are not getting anywhere close to 100%. And this just may be from a single afternoon. To the rich young man, Jesus said, who alone was good. Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. It's a crafty question. Only God is truly good, and all others are sinful. But Jesus is true God and true man. So if the rich young man was calling Jesus good because the man recognized that Jesus is true God, then he would be confessing the right faith, and he would be on the right path. Alas, his spiritual GPS was still on the fritz. It could not direct him the true way, which is faith in Christ alone, who gave his perfect life for sinners and rose from the dead. The rich young man still thought that the wrong directions were the right directions. For Jesus listed out what commandments needed to be kept to be saved 100%, and the man said, "Well, teacher, all these things I have kept from my youth." Oh, poor soul, you can't get there that way. Everlasting salvation is not found on that path. How often you and I will also want to go this direction? How often your sinful nature tells you, you know enough of God's word, Scripture, and you don't need to know any more. As if your work of learning was enough for you to enter heaven. Baptism and confirmation often seems to get perceived as a great work that people can try to enter heaven by doing. Well, at least he was baptized, at least she was confirmed, even though he and she fell away into unrepentant sin and stopped hearing the word from then on. Won't there be many people on the last day who call Jesus Lord and speak of the good works they did in his name? Perhaps being baptized and confirmed in a church? Perhaps they consider their faith a good work they chose to do. But won't Jesus say to many on that day, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. The rich man left Jesus sorrowful since he could not do enough. He could not give his riches away, for they were his false god. Jesus showed him the full extent of the law, and that left him sorrowful. So it is that all are also sorrowful if they try to be saved by doing the works of the law. The law cannot save. Rather, we must be saved from the law. Salvation is possible only by the gospel, only by the perfect life of the only good man laid down in sacrifice for sins, only by faith in that atoning sacrifice. The right spiritual GPS way to everlasting salvation is trusting in Jesus Christ alone, who is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes. The curse of the law is ended. Jesus, who alone is good, declares sinners good. His blood shed for sinners blots out sins and purifies you in the eyes of God for all who believe this. Though you could not keep God's law, Jesus has done it all. It has been completed. Here is the right way to salvation. Here are the best directions from the spiritual GPS, Holy Scripture, and that is trust in Jesus. Works are still to be done to serve your neighbor. Your neighbor needs your good works. But you are now free to serve and not bound to do just enough for your salvation. Jesus, who alone is good, has done what you need, and he freely gives it away to sinners. All who trust this will be saved. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the true faith in Christ Jesus until life everlasting. Amen. Please pray with me as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you peace. Amen. Thank you for viewing Main Street Living this morning. Our hope is that you have been blessed and encouraged by hearing God's Word. If you are able to attend local services, I invite you to worship with our congregations. If you are in the Beamer, Nebraska area, please join us at Emmanuel Lutheran Church Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. If you are near Wisner, Nebraska, services at Zion St. John Lutheran Church begin at 10:30 a.m. This broadcast is supported by viewers like you, and their financial help allows this broadcast to continue. You can join us by sending a contribution of any amount to this address. More information about this program can be found at mainstreetliving.com, including links to other LCMS websites, congregation locations, and additional ways to donate. Thank you again for joining us today, and have a blessed week. We hope to see you again at the same time next Sunday on this station.